وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال الله جل جلاله في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد إن الله
Moment of placing on your scales, inshallah, your good actions will outweigh your
inshallah you learn something from this short reminder of mine. Before I begin, I pray to the Almighty that may He enable me to act upon what I say, to benefit, and then collectively may Allah give us the ability not only to listen with our physical ears, but tonight let's listen with our spiritual ears. Our spiritual ears of our hearts, so that we benefit, so that we learn, and when we go back, we can change the direction of our lives. Say inshallah. This festive season, every year it falls upon us. Last year we were celebrating, this year we're celebrating, and inshallah to our last breath, we will celebrate the Mawlid of Rasulullah. But I want to take your attention, and I want you to ponder for a second that what is actually the reality of celebrating the Mawlid of the Prophet? What's the reason? And for me and you, the Ashiqs, our purpose and objective should be that we should do our muhasaba. We should reflect on our relationship with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Where was it last year? Where do we stand today? Because our salvation is in the connection, rabita, connection, affiliation with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The moment our affiliation is strong with the Prophet of Allah, we will succeed, not only in this dunya, but in barzakh and beyond. But the idea is that Allah has blessed us with this beautiful festive season. Ask yourself a question. Ask yourself a moment. Stop and think that where is your affiliation with the Prophet of Allah? Is it only in the days of Mawlid? Is it only for certain festive seasons? Or throughout your life, are you connected to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So this is a season and a period for us to assess ourselves and to reconnect ourselves with the Prophet of Allah. Because a reconnection with Rasulullah is our salvation. Now let me say that how do we connect ourselves and how do we strengthen our connection and rabita with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And the ulama teaches, and we learn from the people of Ishq and Muhabbat, that primarily the source of connection with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is by sending durood o salam upon him. Say subhanallah. By sending durood o salam upon him. And when we read the verses of Surah Al-Ahzab, we come to learn the azmat and the maqam of Rasulullah. We learn the status of the Prophet of Allah. How? You will not find a single word from the Holy Quran in which Allah, the Creator of all, say, oh, you who believe, I pray namaz, so you pray namaz. You will not find a single verse from 6,666 verses of the Quran in which Allah the Almighty says, oh, believers, I perform Hajj, therefore you perform Hajj. But when Allah comes to show the Ummah, the Matbaa Maqam, status and rank of Nabi alayhi salam, what does Allah say? Allah Jalla Jalaluhu says, Inna Allah wa malaikata yusalluna 'ala an-nabi. Verily Allah and His entire malaika. Some people translate this as Allah and His angels. Like an ayah added a word, which is a correct translation. Allah and His entire malaika. How? Those of you that are familiar with Arabic language, when mudaf is jama, malaika is the jama of malak. And when the mudaf is jama, then this has the meaning of all, entire. So Allah is showing us the status of Rasulullah. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu. Allah and His entire malaika. And shall I give you an understanding so that we can try to comprehend that what is this entire? What does this constitute on? Because no one has the exact number of angels. Well, let me give you an example just to try to comprehend. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, 60,000 angels a day descend down in the Masjid al-Nabawi to give salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
sections again. So inna Allah, verily Allah, and the entire malaika send durood upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, O you who believe, sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. You send durood and you send salam. Durood and salam.
When we give salam, he likes Allah has created
an angel. Allah has created an angel. And the only duty and the only job of that angel is what? He is placed on the minaret in the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Masjid al-Nabawi, this angel, his only duty is to wait for a ashik from anywhere to send salam. And that angel has been honored to present that salam in the barakah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when that salam is presented in the barakah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then what happens? Then the ashik's kismat wakes up, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives a reply mentioning his name and mentioning the name of his father. Send a durood and also salam upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as ashiq, our iman and aqeedah is this, that when we give durood, we are elevated by many statuses. But when we give salam to our beloved, tawajjuh, his spiritual sighting gets when we die from it, as we take the attention of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We capture the attention of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So imagine that moment when you're sat in your home and you're sending in great humbleness, salam upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are actually capturing the tawajjuh of Aqa alayhi salam wa sallam wa sallam. So this is the purpose. As the days of Rabiul Awwal Sharif, Rabiul Nur Sharif are starting, you'll be attending many gatherings. Therefore, I find it important that I speak about this issue, that you have to reflect, ponder, think to yourself, how do I connect myself with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And the point of connection and the procedure of connection is begin reading durood o salam upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that when the Prophet Rabiul Nur, that night which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was blessed into this world, we can have the abundant, so much durood sharif to present to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What a perfect gift from an ashiq to give to his beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And because I touched upon the 12th of Rabiul Awwal, which is the 13th of January, what we want to conclude in regards to this night, in our beloved Rasul, we have to connect ourselves to show that love. My brothers, we claim that we love Rasulullah, but look at the seerah and the biographies of our pious predecessors and how they demonstrated love for Rasulullah. We think by coming to a Mawlid Jami, that's sufficient for me. I'm a ashiq e Rasul. We can shout, Hamid e Rasul, Mawlid e Qabool hai. You know, we can shout all these slogans, but the true connection is your physical and spiritual connection with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That love, look at the famous story, the lady who is informed that your son has died in a battle. She's racing towards the battlefield. She's informed that your son has died in the battlefield. She says, don't tell me about my son. Akhbir me Muhammad. Tell me about Muhammad. She goes further. She's informed that your husband has died in the battle. She goes, no, no, no. Don't tell me about my husband. Akhbir me Muhammad. Tell me about my beloved. She goes, she continues. She's informed that your father has died in the battle. She says, no, no, no. Don't tell me about my father. Akhbir me Muhammad. Tell me about Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So she continues and continues until she reaches the battlefield and she sees that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is safe to herself. She looks at the face of Rasulullah and she says, Ya Rasulullah, fitaha ummi wa abi, my father and mother are sacrificed upon you. I see your beautiful face and all my trials, tribulations are all washed away after seeing the beautiful face of does the zikr of Allah to you now.
Rabta Rishta with Rasulullah is beyond this. Jagan, bro.
Naat Council that have come all the way from Pakistan, and they make our Minar.
Why? Because when Rasulullah comes, I stand up in honor.
people in respect. Another point Allah Azzaz that comes to my mind, which I was to mention to you, when you talk about Allah and Rasul, Imam Ahlul Sunnah says, you know, if you take my heart out and cut it into two parts, what you will see, La ilaha illallah on one side, Muhammad Rasulullah. Our salvation is in the ishq of Rasulullah. Like I said, this season, this festive Maulid season, is your connection with Rasulullah. Connect yourself with the Prophet of Allah. Make him your best friend. Make him your best colleague. Make him your role model, as the Quran instructs us to do so. And how do we do that? From the short reminder, begin reading the Hudud Salam of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. One message, and the final message is that we are worthless, we are useless, we are priceless without the ishq and qabr of Alayhi Salaam Wasallam. Develop that love within yourself, make him your beloved. The moment you make him your beloved, Allah will make you his beloved. And this is why I conclude on this earth. Kiki Muhammad
reconnect ourselves with the beloved. Wa khidr al-wala.